Here's Bosher to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And that's complete to Jesse James. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Ten yards still left on second down. The throw here, Roethlisberger. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Brooks Reed in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. Here we go on fourth down with Roethlisberger. James has got it, complete. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Jesse James, 52 yards. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, oh, okay, forget the field goal because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. On the return, here's Justin Hardy. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Looking deep for Julio. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. And the return across midfield into the 46-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
And the Steelers set to take the field. Now, these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with. I wouldn't be complaining either. I'd want to get right back out there and get after them because now
he rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
Kyle Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
After the interception, here's Ryan. Looking downfield for Jones. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Second down, Freeman. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a third and six here to start things out. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. He's going to wind up and air it out. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell, and he returns it here to his own 18-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down, so the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger, and he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Adrian Claiborne coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And his guys will take over at the 14-yard line in the red zone. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Ryan hit, and he lost the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Hey, I'm all about defense forcing plays and getting takeaways. But an interception and two fumbles in their last three offensive possessions.
Time to readjust.
Yeah, you can't just give all the credit to the defense on that. They've got to look in the mirror and take the blame themselves and figure out how to not do it anymore.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's James. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Back now as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Yeah, thank you. And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by Robert Alford. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Robert Alford just continues to develop as a premier corner in the NFL. Had a monster Super Bowl against New England. His ability to read, diagnose patterns was the key to his pick six in that game.
9 career interceptions into the season, and another one right there. So out come the Falcons now. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for...
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. Gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Evades him at the 10. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.